So welcome back class 6 and today we are going to continue exercise 2.4 from question number 6 to 10. Okay, so these were word problems. Basically linear, we will have to read the statement, then we will make linear equation in one variable, and after that we will solve them by transposing. So let's see first question number 6, that is today's first question. It says there is a narrow rectangular plot reserved for a school in Mahuli village. The length and width of the plots are in the ratio 11:4. Then the next statement is, at the rate rupees 100 per meter, it will cost the village panchayat rupees 75,000 to fence the plot. Okay, let us try to understand. Suppose this is the plot, which is in the shape of a rectangle. And for example, I have to fence it. So fence means like this, we will be doing. This is the fencing, getting or not? So just pay attention, what we are doing here, what we are measuring, this, it means we are measuring the boundary. What we are measuring, if we are fencing any shape, it means we are measuring its boundary. Understood? Okay, how many times if I will start fencing from here? 1, 2, 3, 4. Again, I will come to this point and the fencing will be completed. We are just thinking that we are not making two or three rows. We are just taking it as we are making one row. So it means we have to fence the perimeter of rectangle, and that is given by twice of L plus B. Okay. Now the question says, we have given length and the ratio of length and width, and it is also given that the rate per meter for fencing required rupees 100 per meter. Okay, so how we will calculate the total amount? If it would be, for example, 1 meter, 2 meter, 3 meter, 4 meter, then total cost will be 4 into 100, that will be 400 meter. But in this question we don't know what is the parameter, but we have given the ratio of length and width, so that we will calculate. Understood? So let's start the question. First, we will note down what we have given, and it is given that L is to be given, length is to width is equals to 11:4. Okay, so length is equals to 11x and breadth will be equals to 4x. This you have understood in ratio and proportion chapter or ratio in your previous class. Okay, now let's see, it is given that rate, first what we will calculate, parameter. So parameter is equals to twice of L plus B, that means P is equals to 2 times of 11x plus 4x, and that is equals to P is equals to 11 plus 4 15 and 15 times to 30x. So according to us, this is the parameter. So what will be the cost? So cost of fencing is equals to total length which we have to fence, that is parameter, 30x multiplied by rate per meter, and that is given. Let me write here, cost of fencing per meter. Understood? That is given 100. So this will be 30x into rupees 100, and that will be equals to 3000 x rupees. Understood? Or rupees 3000 x. But according to question, the rate of fencing or the cost of fencing is given 75,000. So this is according to us, that is rupees 3000 x, it is equals to 75,000 rupees, isn't it? Okay, now what we will do, we will find out the value of x. That will be, as you can see, 3 zeros will cancel out, and if we will divide, that will be 25. so far we have find out or we have found out the value of x. Now what will be our next step? We have to find out the dimensions of the plot. So dimensions will be given by 4 times of x and 11 times of x. So I am writing here. So length is equals to, that is 11x. 11x is equals to 11 multiplied by 25. That will be 250 and 25, 275 meter. Understood? And similarly, breadth is equals to 4 into 25, that is 100 meter. Understood? So this is the way by which we have calculated. We have done nothing, we were just using whatever the question was saying. As question has given 75,000 total cost, we have found out the total cost in our way, like by taking length 11x and width 4x. Understood? You pause the video and note it down. Now let us try to understand question number 7. It is very very important kind of question. It says Hasan buys two kind of cloth material for shirt, for school uniform, shirt material and that cost him rupees 50 per meter and trouser material that cost him rupees 90 per meter. So two types of cloth material, for shirt and for trouser, and the cost of shirt material is rupees 50 per meter and the cost of trouser material is rupees 90 per meter. So far this information we have given and we have written it roughly. Next information is, for every 3 meter of shirt material, for every 3 meter of shirt material it requires, she buys, Hasan is a girl, okay, Hasan is a boy, he buys 2 meters of trouser material. This is the information which is saying that if he needs 3 meter shirt material, at the same time he will be needing 2 meter trouser material. Now the next information is, he sells this materials at 12% and 10% profit respectively. It means profit for shirt material is 12% and profit for trouser material is 10%, because it is saying respectively, and from the starting of question we were seeing that first statement was for shirt and second was for trouser. Next is, his total sale is rupees 36,300. This is total sale. Total sale is equals to 36,600. Okay. Now the question is asking, how much trouser material did he buy? We have to find out how many meters of trouser material did he buy. Now let's see what so many things we have given. We have given cost price. These are the cost price. Okay, this is the total selling price. Total selling price, and these are profits on shirt as well as trouser. Okay, and next information, it is very important, for every 3 meter of cloth material for shirt, it requires 2 meter of cloth material of trouser. Suppose if I will buy 6 meter of shirt material, and what will be the length of trouser material I needed? That will be equals to 4. It means this is given in the form of ratio 3:2. Understood? And we don't know that what length of shirt material he bought, so we will take it as a 3x, and at the same time the length of trouser material should be 2x. Getting or not? Okay, so let us write. Let's start. Given we are not writing him, we are just directly solving. Let he buys 3x meter cloth material for shirt and 2x meter cloth material for trouser. For trousers. Understood? Now the next information which we are going to use, it is given, rate, cost price. So cost price, or let me write CP. Okay, in the next line I'll be writing CP. Cost price of shirt material is given by rate of per meter of shirt material multiplied by its total length. So this will be 3x multiplied by 50, isn't it? That will be equals to 150x. This is the total cost price of shirt material. Similarly, cost price of trousers material is given by, again similarly, that will be 2x multiplied by 90, and it is going to give 180x. Why we are calculating cost price? Because here it is given that profit, and as you know that profit, selling price and cost price, there is a relation. Profit percent is given by CP, SP, profit upon CP into 100. That's why we are calculating total cost price. And also pay attention, this is total sale means total SP. Total SP means selling price of shirt plus selling price of trouser. That's why we will have to calculate total cost price. So total CP is given by sum of these two, 150x plus 180x. It will be x 0, 230x. Understood? So 230x is total cost price. Now let's see. But first, what we will have to calculate? We will have to calculate profit differently. Okay, so we do not require total cost price, because what we are doing, we do not require total cost price. Let's see here. This is the total cost price of shirt material, and here it is given that profit is 12%. So let us calculate the selling price. Selling price of shirt material is equals to CP plus, what is the profit? 12%. 12% of CP, isn't it? So this will be 150x plus 12% means 12 upon 100 multiplied by 150x. Now that will be equal to, if you will be solving, so this will be 5 2 times 10, 5 3 times 15, and 6 18. So this will be 100, 6 3 18, 168x. This is the cost selling price of shirt material. Similarly, SP of trouser, SP of trousers material is given by CP of trouser, that is here it is 180x plus profit was 10%, 10 over 100 multiplied by 180x. Again, let us solve it. This will be or 18. So that will be 180x plus 18.
12% तक 150 का 15 17 गड़बड़ गई यार, 150 का 12% 15 18 ये भी सही है, 150 160 और 68 18
Okay, so it was given that we have found out up to here, this is 366x, but according to question, the total selling price was equals to 36,600, and according to us, it is 366x, so we have equated them, then we have found out the value of x, hence the question was asking about length of trouser material, that is, we have assumed it as a 2x. So by putting the value of x, we'll be getting the answer that the length of trouser material which he bought, it was 200 meter. Understood? Okay, pause the video and note it down. Now let's see question number 8. It says, this is kind of a riddle. Let's see question number 8. It says, half of herd of deer are grazing in the field and 3/4 of the remaining are playing nearby. The rest means bache hue, are drinking water from the pond. The rest nine. Find the number of deers in the herd. First, what we will do, it is written find the number of deers in the herd. So we will assume that as x. So let us assume, let there are x deers in the herd means group of deer, it is said herd. Okay, now question says, we are going to just writing it as according to question, half of the herd of the deer are grazing in the field. So number of deer grazing in the field, it says half of the deer in the herd, half of the, how many deers are there, x, so it will be half of x by 2. Okay, next information is and 3/4 of the remaining, let us find out remaining. If suppose I have there are 10 deers and half of the deers are grazing in the field, it means 5 are grazing in the field, then remaining will be 10 minus 5, so remaining will be given by total number of deer minus number of deers who are grazing in the field, and as you understand it very well that it will be equals to x upon 2. So these are remaining. Now the question says 3/4 of the remaining are playing nearby. So how many are playing? We are writing here playing is equals to 3/4 of remaining. 3/4 of remaining. And here we can see clearly 3/4 of means multiplied and remaining are x by 2. So these are remaining, these are playing, means 3x over 8 are playing. Okay, next information is the rest 9 are drinking water from the pond. Pay attention here. Now the digit 9 which we have given, इट इज़ रिटन बिफोर दैट दैट द रेस्ट. द रेस्ट मीन्स एट द लास्ट वट वी हैव. लुक हेयर, टोटल वॉज एक्स. आउट ऑफ दैट एक्स बाई टू वॉज प्लेइंग. गेटिंग और नॉट? ओके. एंड थ्री बाई फोर्थ ऑफ द रिमेनिंग मीन्स थ्री अपॉन एट एक्स आर. दीज आर ग्रेजिंग, दीज आर प्लेइंग. एंड नाउ द क्वेश्चन इज सेइंग द रेस्ट नाइन. व्हाट द क्वेश्चन इज सेइंग? क्वेश्चन इज सेइंग रेस्ट नाइन. इट मीन्स इफ हाउ वी विल फाइंड आउट द रिमेनिंग, वी विल सब्ट्रैक्ट दिस प्लस दिस फ्रॉम टोटल. नॉट गेटिंग? ओके, लेट अस टेक वन मोर एग्जाम्पल. इफ आई एम सेइंग वी हैव टोटल 10. How many? We have total 10. 5 are grazing and 3 are playing. Then what will be the rest amount? Can you tell me how you will find out? How you will find out? What you will do? Here it will be total minus sum of grazing plus playing. 10 minus 8 is going to give 2. So 2 will be rest. Understood? So same thing we will be using here. Pay attention. So, number of beers drinking is given by, according to us, it would be total minus number of deers who are grazing, that is x upon 2, and minus number of deers who are playing, that is 3x upon 8. Let us simplify it. That LCM will be 8. This will be 8x minus 4x minus 3x. That will be equals to x upon 8. But according to question, this number of beers drinking, that is x upon 8, that should be equals to, what was it given? 9. So that will be equals to 9 times 8, that is 72. Understood? So, number of deer in the herd is 72. Not is, actually it should be R. Number of deer in the herd are 72. Understood? Okay, pause the video and note it down. Now let's see question number 9. And these are questions which are based on age, and I have told you many questions like this in our previous exercises. So let us see one more question. It says a grandfather is 10 times older than his granddaughter. Okay. Next information is he means grandfather is also 54 years older than her. Her means granddaughter. And we have to find their present ages. As I have taught you that we will assume only the age of one person, that is equals to x. And in most of the question I have given you hint that 99.9% you should go, or you should assume the age of younger one as x. So here granddaughter will be younger one. So let the present age of granddaughter be x years. Then pay attention here. Age of grandfather, that is 10 times of granddaughter, so this will be 10x. Also, again it is given, also age of grandfather, it is given that the grandfather is 54 years older than her. It means if in the present age of granddaughter we will add 54, then we will be getting the age of grandfather. So as you can see, it says age of grandfather is 10x, it says age of grandfather is x plus 54. These all are according to question, so we can equate them. The left side of this equation is are आइडेंटिकल. सो टेन एक्स शुड बी इक्वल्स टू एक्स प्लस 54 और 9x इक्वल्स टू 54, एक्स विल बी इक्वल्स टू 9 टाइम्स 6. सो वी हैव फाउंड आउट द एज ऑफ ग्रैंड डॉटर. सो एज ऑफ ग्रैंड डॉटर इज 6 ईयर्स एंड एज ऑफ ग्रैंडफादर इज 10 टाइम्स ऑफ ग्रैंड डॉटर्स एज, दैट विल बी 60 ईयर्स. अंडरस्टूड? Understood? This was so simple. Similarly, question number 10, you will do yourself. It says Aman's age is 3 times his son's age. What we will be doing, we will be assume that the son's age is x years, then Aman's age will be 3x. Then the question says 10 years ago, it means talking about past 10 years ago, Aman's present age will be x minus 10 and son's age will be x minus, son's age was x minus 10 and Aman's age was 3x minus 10, and according to question he was 5 times his son's age. So what we'll be doing, Aman's age 10 years ago should be equals to 5 multiplied by son's age 10 years ago, so it would be 3x minus 10 is equals to 5 multiplied by x minus 10, and by solving that you will be able to find out their present ages. Understood? Okay, so that's all for today, and in the next video we will be solving exercise 2.5. if you have any problem in this section, you can ask me by sending your message through WhatsApp. Understood? Okay, goodbye, have a nice day, and Jai Hind. See you in the next video.